remarkable day in federal parliament today when Independent MP Zali Stegall spoke to us about a bill that she was proposing to put to parliament to cancel the PEP11 oil and gas exploration permit, PEP11, in the parliament today, basically because the decision by Resources Minister Keith Pitt has not come, despite assurances from the Prime Minister and Liberal Party members. This is what Zali had to say this morning before the bill was put.
I think the communities have had enough of waiting. We've had a lot of platitudes from especially coalition MPs along the coast saying that this project won't go ahead. But the reality is the licence holder is going ahead. You have interviewed them. They believe this project is on foot. They are putting out to tender for materials to proceed. So we need to call time on this ridiculous project. This is the Morrison government's gas folly off our coast, and it's just not acceptable. So my real question is, who's in control of this government? You know, if the Prime Minister says he doesn't support the project, yet his minister, Keith Pitt, a Queensland National, is insisting that appears to be considering it and could very well approve the project shortly.
Well, that was today, this morning. Things didn't quite go to plan for the proponents of the debate and the bill in Parliament. This is what Emma McBride and Lucy Wicks had to say in the debate.
And is long overdue. Yeah. You can speak up in this House and you can say another thing in your electorate. You need to do the right thing on PEP 11 for all of us and call on the Minister to make a decision today. This is with a stroke of a pen. We don't need this private member's bill, although we fully support it because the government won't act.
And that is why the motion before the House this morning really achieves nothing for communities up and down the New South Wales coast.
Didn't go to plan when the motion was put to suspend standing orders and debate the bill. The vote went in 48 to 52. That is to say that the coalition members, Lucy Wicks, Jason Falinski and Dave Sharma, didn't vote for debating the bill, surprisingly, and therefore the bill was defeated. It won't even be debated. Now, this despite those three Liberal members assuring their local communities that they were against the drilling for oil and gas off the coast. There's more to come about that. See the full story in tomorrow's papers.